you know, foreign policy experience has been a huge issue in this campaign because you guys made it a big issue in this campaign, pointing out time and time again, as you did, that John McCain had far more experience than Barack Obama and that nothing, in your view, was more important in the campaign than the ability to be commander-in-chief. So I don't have to tell you that there's a feeling out there by some that you're not holding your VP pick to your own standard, the standard that you defined. So explain to us why you think Governor Palin is ready to be commander-in-chief.
Governor Palin has the good fortune of being on the ticket with John McCain, who there is no question is the most experienced and shown proven judgment on the international stage. He understands foreign affairs. He has a familiarity with the
players. Well, we know all that about John McCain, Tucker. I asked you about her, though, because we all know the role of the VP, as John McCain has defined it, is to be able to step into the job of the presidency on day one if something should happen to the president. So I'm asking you about her foreign policy experience.
Yeah, Campbell, certainly there are a number of people that are supporting Barack Obama's candidacy and feel like he's experienced enough to take on the Oval Office. Our feeling is
that Governor Palin has just as much experience
as Barack Obama.
Okay, but you set a different standard.
That was the candidate of our opponent.
What I'm saying is that you set a different standard by arguing how important it was with John McCain, and no one's arguing with you that he has much more experience than Barack Obama, so I'm just trying to get someone from the campaign to explain to me what foreign policy experience she has or what qualifications she has that would allow her to be ready to be commander-in-chief if something should happen to Senator McCain.
Well, Campbell, let me be clear. I don't think there should be any problem explaining her experience. She has executive state level experience. She's been in public office reforming Washington. She's been in executive office longer and more in a more effective sense than Barack Obama's been in the United States Senate. She's been the commander of the National Guard of the Alaska,
Tucker,
that's been deployed overseas. That's foreign policy experience.
If I can interrupt for 1 second. Commander, because I've heard you guys say this a lot. Can you just tell me one decision that she made as commander-in-chief of the Alaska National Guard? Just one.
Yeah, she has made any decision she has made as the commander of the National Guard that's deployed overseas is more of a decision than Barack Obama has been making as he's been running for president for the last 2 years.
Okay, so tell me. Give me an example of one of those decisions. I'm just curious. Just one decision she made in her capacity as commander-in-chief of the National Guard.
Campbell, certainly you don't mean to belittle every experience, every judgment that she makes as commander of the National Guard.
I'm belittling nothing. I just want to know one judgment or one decision. Well, I would love to know what one decision was. I'm not belittling anything, Tucker. I'm really not. I'm curious.
As she makes a decision as to how to equip, how to command the National Guard of the in Alaska, that's more of a judgment than Barack Obama's making on the campaign trail. That's my only argument.
No governor makes decisions about how to equip or deploy the National Guard. That, you know, when they go to Iraq, those decisions, as you well know, are made by the Pentagon.
Campbell, on a factual basis, they certainly do. In Alaska, if you have any sort of emergency, as things are happening in your state, the National Guard is under the command of the governor. That is more of a command role than Barack Obama has ever had. I would argue that on our ticket, John McCain and Governor Palin, between the two of them, have far more command experience in the military than either of the candidates on the Democratic side. And I do want to argue that this is about the top of the ticket. Ultimately, when people go into the ballot box and decide between Barack Obama and John McCain, they're going to decide between John McCain's record of reforming Washington and Barack Obama's rhetoric on the campaign trail. Doesn't have a lot of experience, certainly has no military experience, no command military experience, which both of our candidates have. That's an important distinction. I think voters will make the right call in November.
All right, Tucker, I'm gonna just give it to you, baby. We'll end it there,
Thank you, Kevin. I appreciate that.